Okay, so tell me if this sounds familiar. You've always taken a lot of notes, but you never see them again, and you never make something useful with them. Napkin is a tool that aims to change that. Instead of writing and then leaving your notes to rot as you take new ones, Napkin connects your past notes to your new ones, so you can see the whole picture. A few years back, I came across this concept of the mind garden. The idea of which is that you treat your mind like a garden in the sense that you carefully choose the kind of seeds that you want to plant, and then you nurture the plants and place similar ones close together so that they can better grow together. So I thought it was super interesting, but it also sounded like too much work. And the reason that I thought it's interesting in the first place is that if you think about it, serendipity exists in real life. And that's where insights occur, connections take place, and ideas are born and shaped. Whereas in digital environments, we have a lot more control, but that extra control also means extra work and less serendipity. So it's not typically as easy to use digital tools to generate insights and shape your ideas. Apps encourage us to collect stuff without ever using them. So enter Napkin. When I came across it, I was captivated by the way the developers described it. No more folders. No more spending hours manually tagging everything. Instead of that, a place where you get clarity, make connections between concepts, and nurture your ideas. It sounded great, but honestly, I didn't think that I would ever pay $8 to $10 per month to use it. But having used it for a while, I know that I will. And the great thing is that if I ever change my mind, I'm not logged in. I can export my data in CSV and JSON at any moment. And these are widely supported standard formats. It's really thoughtful that the makers make it so easy to switch away from Napkin, and it goes to show how much they believe in their product. But I don't want to switch, because this layer that Napkin adds on top of your data is super valuable. I would describe it as having a twin that goes over the notes you've captured and tags them the way that you would have. So once you come back to them, they make sense in context. So you hardly ever have to do any work yourself. It's like the work is done for you, but by someone who thinks like you. For example, like most people, I'm interested in a lot of topics. In a traditional note-taking application, if I have an idea that relates to any of those topics, I would have to place it in the relevant notebook. But with Napkin, if I have, say, an app idea on any topic, I just send the idea to Napkin without telling it that it's an app idea. And then when I come back to it, I see that the thought has been tagged correctly as an app idea in the relevant topic. But that's not where it stops, because it also shows me other related thoughts that might help me develop that idea further. So what is it like using Napkin day to day? Well, first you have to capture notes. You can either do that through the web app by hitting space and typing something, or by highlighting text and sending it to Napkin via the Chrome extension, or by doing either of those things through the mobile app. That's currently available on iOS only, but there's also a fan-made Android version that works pretty well, and that's what I use. Okay, so where do these notes go? They stay in your inbox, and the idea is that from time to time you would go through the inbox note by note, and usually you wouldn't do anything to them. But occasionally you might want to delete a tag or add another one. And that's how Napkin learns to use tags the way you would. So let's say you're working on project X. So you capture a thought that relates to it. You use the tag a couple of times, and then Napkin learns to recognize when a thought could be related to project X, sometimes even if you don't. That only works for new notes, but Napkin more or less ensures that you're going to be exposed to your old notes as well, and you can always add that tag manually to them when you do. For example, here I took a note without realizing that it relates to the concept of the beginner's mindset. Napkin correctly identified that it does and tagged it accordingly. Now I can see it as part of my collection of thoughts on the particular topic. Then let's say that you need to write an article, make a YouTube video, write an essay, understand a topic, or maybe you just like exploring concepts like a philosopher for fun. There's this feature that's called Stacks that lets you cherry-pick your notes and sort them so that you can make something out of them, like the outline for an article. You can even add sections and sticky notes that live only within that stack. And once you're ready, you can copy the entire text and start writing in another app. There's also this other feature that they call Moments, which are like playlists for thoughts. Right now, you have a moment for thoughts that you haven't seen in a while, and for those that are not connected to others. But in the future, they're going to add more. So why use Napkin over another app? Well, in other apps, you have to manually tag and categorize everything. And even if it's really easy to do, you are still the one that has to do it. Napkin also lets you link two thoughts to each other manually, but that's not the focus of the app. Other apps are typically more suited for long-form writing, research, and journaling. And that's not what Napkin is supposed to do at all, so it does not compete with them. Instead, in Napkin, you have to do very little work to maintain your notes, and it's more suited for random ideas or for capturing quotes that resonate. So if you hear something and you go like, okay, this made me feel something and I don't want to lose it, you send it to Napkin. And in there, it's gonna marinate alongside these other thoughts So in the end, you're going to have this soup that you can actually put to use instead of just having the ingredients that make it up. And because Napkin wants you to combine your ideas and create something new, note cards are small on purpose. If you write more than about 40 words, the rest will only be shown if you click the note. And that's to keep you from writing notes that combine multiple ideas and are harder to use as building blocks. So as you've realized, Napkin is not a note-taking app in the usual sense. It's not a place where you would write down a grocery list, but more of a place for philosophical thoughts, solving problems and shaping ideas. All that said, I don't think it's perfect yet. It is good enough, but I would definitely like to see a more polished design, an official Android app, a Firefox extension, maybe even a Telegram bot. Then there would have to be a way to visualize tags. Which are the most popular ones? Like, what am I even writing about? And how do these concepts overlap? Maybe there could be a word cloud. I know this is something that the makers are exploring right now, so here's hoping they release it soon. Then you know how sometimes you have an idea, you note it down, it feels like an aha moment, but then you realize that you've taken that exact same note before, but you phrased it differently. It would be so cool if Napkin could detect that those are duplicates and tell you about it. Then I would like an improved search experience, because now it's just a tiny sidebar, I would like to be the entire screen and give me more control. And this might be a bit out of scope, but I would like it if there was an extra pane next to stacks so that I could write some long form content on one side and see my stack on the other. Now, I highly recommend that you try out Napkin, but there are some things that you should keep in mind. First, this is a very young app, so it might not be around next year. But the more people that use it and pay for it, the more likely it is that it's gonna stay. Secondly, this is a beta product, which means it's a work in progress, so the makers often play around with the design and add or remove features. Thirdly, there's the price. As of 2022, there is a 30-day free trial, but after that, you have to either pay $100 per year, which is what I'm gonna do once my trial runs out, or $10 per month. There's also that $300 lifetime plan. Now, personally, I'm gonna pay for it because I've seen the benefits and I like them. So first, I have more ideas now because, you know, the more ideas you write down, the more of them you get. And these ideas are not just sitting in a vacuum, but Napkin helps me add to them and develop them over time. Then I've also noticed that my memory has improved. I sometimes find myself repeating quotes in conversation. You might be familiar with the concept of spaced repetition. It's what apps like Duolingo use to help you learn new words. Napkin does not have spaced repetition as a feature, but it's what it indirectly does, because every time you take a new note or you search for one, you never see only that one note. It always shows you related ones on the side. And that way, you're constantly re-exposed to your previous thoughts, and that ensures that they stick. So these have been my thoughts on Napkin. You might notice that I'm listed as a testimonial on their website, and that's because I like the product. I sent them some feedback over email and they said, hey, since you like it, would you mind writing a review for our website? And I did. But I'm not affiliated with them beyond the fact that I like the product and I often send them feedback. So the video is not sponsored by Napkin in any way, but I do have an affiliate link down below. You don't have to use it, but I would appreciate it. And if you do, I will get a commission if you decide to purchase a subscription. So I do hope you'll use Napkin at least for the 30-day free trial. You can always export your notes, so you're not going to lose the time that you invest collecting them. I really think it has the potential to change the way you approach taking notes and shape your ideas. Thank you for watching, and be sure to hit the like button. I sometimes upload reviews like this one when I really like something, so if you've enjoyed this one, consider subscribing. I'll link my latest video here.